And the drug design process is, I like to use the phrase, it's not rocket science. It's much harder than that. Alzheimer's disease is, you know, is really a terrible neurodegenerative disease that is typified by what we call four different phenotypes. One is the buildup of what we call amyloid plaques. The second is what we call neurofibrillary tangles. We also see neural inflammation, and obviously, as most people know, a very sobering and disturbing slow decline in cognition. There is no cure for Alzheimer's disease. It is a huge unmet medical need. There are drugs approved for Alzheimer's which treat symptoms, but that's about it really. The approaches that people are taking towards Alzheimer's typically target these four different phenotypes. They don't target all of them. And the idea is that by successfully targeting one or two of those phenotypes, that will lead to a subsequent concomitant improvement in cognitive deficits. I simply identified a protein in the literature that seems to be implicated in all three of these phenotypic observations that you see with Alzheimer's. So the simple concept was, if we came up with a small molecule that could bind to this protein and inhibit its function, potentially we could mitigate the formation of amyloid plaques, check, one hypothesis done, the formation of neurofibrillary tangles, check, and also reduce neural inflammation as well. And if you do all that, you then expect there to be improvements in cognitive deficits. And as a medicinal chemist, it is a far greater challenge to design drugs that need to act in the CNS as opposed to drugs that just need to act in the periphery. When you actually design drugs that are required to get into the brain, that's far more challenging because of something that we call the blood-brain barrier, designed by nature to actually protect the brain. And so what we actually have to do is overcome that barrier with regards to a variety of different properties that the molecule needs to have to permeate that barrier to get into the brain. It's a far more challenging endeavor, and I think, you know, in academia, you really need to take on big problems.